Hi guys! Welcome to another episode of Learn Math with Sir Mark. And in this video, I'm going to discuss arithmetic series, which is actually the continuation of my video on arithmetic sequence, in which you can find the link on the video description below. Okay? So, before anything else, please don't forget to subscribe on my channel, Learn Math with Sir Mark. Let's begin! Okay, when we say arithmetic series, that is the sum of the terms of the arithmetic sequence, right? So first, what I'm going to do here is to derive the formula. Okay, we know we denote the symbol for the sum of the arithmetic sequence as S sub n, right? So that is the sum of the first term, okay, plus the second term, which can be written as A plus B, right, plus the third term, okay, which can be written as a plus 2d, and so on, right? Plus, okay, then yung third to the last, okay, we can rewrite it as the last term minus 2d, right? Plus the second to the last, that can be written as a sub n minus b, and lastly, the last term is a sub n, okay? See that? Okay, so what I'm going to do here is that I'm going to rewrite it in such a way, pag si-switchin ko ng place yung first and last term, the second to the last term, and so on. Okay? So that is, so instead of A, or the first term, so I'm going to write the last term. Okay? Plus, okay, yung second to the last ko, which is A sub N minus B, plus yung third to the last ko, which is A sub N minus 2D, plus, and so on, plus yung third term ko, which is A plus 2D, plus yung second term ko, which is A plus B, and lastly, yung first term ko, which is A. See that? Now, I'm going to add all the terms. Okay, so hindi pantay. Now, S sub N plus S sub N, that is 2 S sub N, right? Then, A plus A sub N, so that will be like that. So you cannot combine them, alright? Plus, A plus B plus A sub N minus B, notice, maka-cancel lang yung D, right? So what will be left here is that A plus A sub N, okay? Doing the same, A plus 2D plus A sub N minus 2D, maka-cancel din yung 2D. So what will be left here is again, A plus A sub N. See that? Actually, maka-cancel lang lahat yan, right? Hanggang sa dulo. So, therefore, so manotice nyo, okay, hanggang sa last term natin, pag inad natin yan, that is A sub N plus A. Right? Now, ang tanong, pare-parehas yan, ilang lahat yan? Ilang terms lahat yan? So, since A sub N represents the last term, the number of terms, so therefore, okay, there are actually n terms. Okay, so that is n times, okay, a plus a sub n. See that? So therefore, like I said, we're going to derive the formula for the sum of the first n terms of arithmetic sequence. So that is s sub n is equal to n over 2 times the first term plus the last term. Okay, see that? So this is the formula, okay, in finding the arithmetic series. Okay? Now, in the event that wala tayong last term, kung hindi given yung a sub n, okay, this is the alternative formula, okay? So, n over 2, okay, times, okay, so like I said, kung hindi given yung nth term, pwede mo naman siyang i-represent as yung a sub n equals a sub 1 plus n minus 1d, right? So this will be your alternative formula. So that will be 2 times the first term plus n minus 1d. And you are all familiar with this one since this is the formula in finding the nth term, right? Okay, there you go. See that? So these are the two formulas that we're going to use in dealing with the problems that I'm going to present later on. Okay? So, let's have problem number 1. Okay. A popular A popular story in the history of math tells us that as a young student, the mathematician Gauss, okay, si Carl Friedrich Gauss, okay, was talkative and restless in class. So his teacher decided to keep him busy by telling him to add up all the whole numbers to 100. The teacher was shocked when the young Gauss produced the correct answer within a minute. So, Gauss may have used the method of pairing the first and the last numbers and making more pairs as he worked in from both ends. Okay? So, the question here is, how many pairs will be formed? Okay, actually, the way I derived the formula is something na parang ganun yung ginawa ni Gauss. Okay, so, sabi niya, di ba, we're going to add the numbers 1 to 100, that is 1 plus 2 plus 3, okay, plus and so on. Sa gitna, meron tayong 50, right, plus 51, plus and so on, plus 98, plus 99, and lastly, plus 100. Okay, so in short, yan yung pinagawa nung teacher, okay, pina-add kay Gauss. So what he did, okay, so in-add niya yung, ginawa niyang pairs, okay, ginawa niyang pairs. So in-add niya to, yung last term, okay, then in-add din to, okay, and so on, until ma-add niya yung nasa gitna. Ang tanong, how many pairs will be formed? So since 1 to 50 yan, tapos ito yung other half, so therefore, the answer in letter A is there are 50 pairs. See that? Now, in letter B, what will be the value of the sum in each pair? So like I said, pinair niya yung dulo. 1 plus 100 is 101, right? 2 plus 99 is another 101. 3 plus 98 is 101, and so on. And then hanggang sa gitna, 50 plus 51 is 101. Okay, so therefore, ibig sabihin, kagaya ng ginawa natin sa derivation ng formula, look, there are n times a plus a sub n. So it's just like, so since 50 pairs yan, 50 na ano, yung sum ng dalawang dulo, okay, which is 101. So therefore, the sum of all the whole numbers from 1 to 100 is simply 50 times 101 or 5,050. Okay? Clear? Okay, let's proceed to the next item, number 2. Okay, this is a classic problem, okay? A clock chimes every hour. Okay, the clock chimes once at 1 o'clock, twice at 2 o'clock, and so on. The question is, how many times will the clock chime from 1 p.m. through the midnight? Okay, so concentrate muna tayo dun sa first question. Okay, so like I said, so pag 1 p.m. daw, okay, 1 in the afternoon, it will chime once. Tama? 2 p.m., okay, it will chime twice, and so on. Now, so since 12 midnight nyan, okay, pagdating ng 12 midnight, it will chime 12 times. So, therefore, yun na. So, all you have to do is to get the sum of the first 12 terms. So, di ba? So, that's simply yung formula natin, n over 2, okay, times the first term plus the last term, which is a sub 12. That's it. So that is, so since n ko is 12, okay, so palitan ko na yan. Alright, so this one will become 12. So that will be 6 times 1 plus 12. Right? So we know 6 times 13 is simply 78. So this is the question, the answer in the first question. Alright, so meaning to say, from 1 o'clock in the afternoon up to 12 midnight, it will chime 78 times. Now, how about the clock will chime in a 24-hour period? So it's just the same. So, diba, from 1 p.m. to 12 midnight, it will chime 78 times. Okay? Now, babalik ulit siya ng 1 a.m. to 12 noon, another 78 yun. So all you have to do is just to multiply this by 2. So 78, okay, times 2, that will be 156. Clear? Okay, let's move to problem number 3. Okay, so the number of seats in the first 14 rows of the center orchestra aisle of the Aliyev Theater in Pasay City form an arithmetic sequence as shown. Okay, So, how many seats are in the 14th row? Okay, so, and then the second question, how many seats in total are in the first 14th row? So now, okay, it's important to study or to examine the illustration. Okay, kasi walang binigay dito. Okay, but looking at the illustration, makukuha natin yung a sub 1, right? On the first row, we have 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11. So in the first row, meron akong 11, right? Okay, on the second row, okay, ilan kaya? 2, 4, 6, 8, 10, 12. Okay, so meaning to say, kung arithmetic sequence yan, okay, arithmetic sequence ang sabi, it follows ang common difference ko, 1. Right? You can count it if you want, yung row 3 natin, that will be 13 seats, row 4 will be 14 seats, and so on. Now, question kasi, how many seats are there in the 14th row? So, therefore, we're looking for that number of seats in the 14th row, okay? So, we have to get a sub 14, all right? And we know that's given by the first term plus, sulat muna yung formula if you already forgot it. So, a sub n is equal to a plus n minus 1 d, right? So, since we're after for the 14th term, that is 14 minus 1 is 13, D. Right? So that's it. So since I already have the first term, I already have the common difference, so makukuha ko na yung number of seats on the 14th row. So that is 11 plus 13 times 1. So that will give you, okay, that will give you 24. See that? Now, I already have the 14th, the number of seats on the 14th row, makukuha ko na yung total number of seats. Okay, it's just like adding 11 plus 12 plus 13 plus and so on plus 23 up to 24. So that's simply S sub 24. Okay. Oh no, 14 lang pala, sorry. Okay, 24 yung at A14. So S sub 14, that's equal to 14 over 2. Okay, times the first term, which is 11, plus the last term, or the 14th term, which is 24. There you go. So that's it. That's 7 times 35. So therefore, ang 7 times 35, that's 35, 21 plus 3, 245. Again, yung sum ng chairs or sum ng seats from the first row up to the 14th row is 245. Clear? Okay. Okay. Example number 4. The first term of an arithmetic progression is 1 if the sum of the first 9 terms is 3 times as large as the sum of the first 5 terms. What is the common difference of this progression? Okay. So, what we have here in sabi, yung first term natin is 1. So, a sub 1 or a, I'll just use a as 1. Okay? Then, sabi sa problem, the sum of the first 9 terms, okay, again, we denote it by S sub 9, okay, is 3 times as large as the sum of the first 5 terms. Okay, so meaning to say, yung S sub 9 is equal to 3 times S sub 5. See that? Okay, now the question is, what is the common difference? Okay, now, what we have is the first term, we don't have the last term. So, what we're going to do here is to use this formula, okay? So, again, like I said, walang first last term na na-mention. So, what we're going to do is this. Okay, 2a plus n minus 1d, okay? Note that meron akong n, right? Your n can be 9 or 5, okay? Yung a is given, okay? And from there, makukuha ko yung d. Clear? Okay, so what I'm going to do is to follow this condition. S sub 9 is equal to 3 times S sub 5. That is 9 over 2, okay, 9 over 2 times 2 times 1. My A is 1, right? 2 times 1 is 2, plus my N is 9, right? So that will be 9 minus 1 or 8D. Clear? Next, 3 times, okay, s of 5. Okay, like what we did here. Okay, so that will be 5 over 2. Okay, times, again, my first term is 1, so that will be 2 plus 5 minus 1, or 4d. There you go. Then we can now proceed dun sa calculation. So, maka-cancel yung 1 half, right? Okay, so then maka-cancel tong 3. So, this one will become 3, right? Okay, then this one will become, distribute ko na. So, pwede yung maging 6 plus 24d, okay, equals 10, distribute ko yung 5, so that will be 10 plus 20d. See that? Then that's it. Combine like terms. Makukuha mo na yung common difference. That is, 24d minus 20d will become 4d. Then, 10 minus 6 will become 4. Clearly, the common difference of this progression is 1. See that? Okay, we're now on the last problem on this video. Before I proceed, so I encourage everyone so to please subscribe on my channel, Learn Math with Sir Mark. Okay, so let's have number 5. The sum of the first 3 terms of an arithmetic progression is negative 3, while the sum of the first 5 terms of the same progression is 10. The question is, find the common difference. Okay, alright. So, ang sabi sa problem, yung sum ng first 3 terms, or S of 3, is equal to negative 3, right? While the sum of the same progression, first 5 terms niya, is equal to 10. Now, the question is, what is the common difference? Okay, so again, we don't, ito lang given natin, wala tayong first term, wala tayong last term, okay? So, what I'm going to do here is that use the second formula, okay? So, that is, S of n equals n over 2, times twice the first term plus n minus 1 d. Okay? Okay. So, now, so since S of 3 is negative 3, so that will be negative 3, alright? Then, ano yung n? That's 3. See that? Okay. Times, okay, unknown yung first term ko, okay, but I have n, which will be 3 minus 1, that will be 2, times the common difference. Alright, so actually, pwede mo na itong masimplify. So, look, 3 and 3 yan, so pwede ko na yan i-cancel. Alright? So, and then yung 1 half dito, if I'm going to distribute 1 half, okay, so ma-cancel yung 2 dyan, right? So, that will be negative 1 equals A plus D. Clear? Okay? Now, what do you notice? So, again, we are after for the common difference, right? We're after for D. But we have A. So, we need to eliminate A. Okay? So, since isang equation lang to that contains two variables, you need another equation. Alright? So, for the meantime, let me call this equation number 1. Now, saan ko kukunin yung second equation ko? Dito sa second given, which is S of 5 equals 10. Alright? Using the same formula, okay? The sum of the fifth term is 10. Okay? My N is 5. Alright, that will be 5 over 2 times the first term, okay, twice the first term, plus n minus 1, which is 5 minus 1, or 4, times d. There you go. Okay, like what we did dito, okay, so pwede kong i-cross-multiply to, that will be 20 over 5. Alright, 20 over 5, that will be 4. Tama? That will be 4 equals 2a plus 4d. Okay, dapat dinistribute ko na yung one upper. Anyway, it will give you the same. Okay, so that will be dividing both sides by 2. Okay, this one will become 2 equals a plus 2d. So, erase ko na lang kasi wala na akong space. Okay, that will be, like I said, 2 equals a plus 2d. So, this will be your equation number 2. Okay, so I'm going to transfer my first equation, that will be negative 1 equals a plus d. There you go. So again, what I'm going to do here is to find a way how to eliminate a so that mauko yung common difference, right? That is, subtract mo lang or multiply negative 1 on the second, on the first equation. That is, 2 minus negative 1, okay, that will be 3, okay, maka-cancel to. 2d minus d is equal to d. There you go. So, makukuha mo na ngayon yung common difference. Okay? So, that's d equals 3. Okay, so I hope you learned something on this video. So, don't forget to subscribe on my channel so that you'll be updated on the next videos that I'm going to upload soon. Keep safe.